Hello, my name is Keshwani. That's K-E-S-H-W-A-N-I, Keshwani. We are here because we want to prepare for the GMAT. We have been solving GMAT math problems out of this book here, GMAT Review, the official guide, the 13th edition. If you do not own this book already, purchase one immediately. You're going to need it. The book contains 230 problem solving questions. It contains 174 data sufficiency questions. We have already solved every single math problem from this book. If you're interested in watching the original solutions to any one of these problems, you will find the original solutions from day number 1 through 250. Right now, we are in the process of redoing the problems, and we are on page number 168. Please turn to it, page number 168, the very first problem that we see in the second column, number 118. We are told that Club X has more than 10 but fewer than 40 members. So we know the total number of members we are told. Club has, let's make a note of it here, 118. We are told that the club has between 10 and 40 members. That's all we are told. We are told that the club has members that are more than 10 but fewer than 40. Which means, let's put down, we're going to use letter T for total, which means the total that we have is can be written as a quantity that is between 10 and 40. So far, so good. We are told that sometimes we are told that these members in the club, they sit in this fashion. They sit three at one table, and four at others. This is the arrangement, that's how they sit. I don't know why, but that's just the way it is. Sometimes they sit in this configuration where three people sit at this one particular table and all the others sit at four each at other tables. Some other times they sit, we are told, again three at one table and five at others. That's it. Those are the only two configurations. In other words, we never have a situation, anything other than that, we never have a situation where we find that there are three people sitting at one table, and then four at some others, and five at some others, or two at some others. There are no other configurations. These are the only two configurations that we are told. This is how the seating arrangement is made. Three at one table, and then sometimes four at each of the other tables, and some other times five at each of the other table. This plot is thickening, isn't it? Let's see what we can do here. The question simply is, how many members does the club have? Let's find out, shall we? Let's find out. Well, first thing we notice is that in both configuration, this part, this element is constant, 3 at one table. So if we call T as the total number of members, then T minus 3 here, watch what happens. Okay, pay very close attention because plot is going to thicken very, very rapidly. So T minus 3 represents the number of people. This T minus 3 represents the number of people, all the number of people who are sitting either 4 at each of the tables or 3 or 5 at each of the other tables. If they're sitting 4 at each of the tables, then that can be written as 4 times, let's call it M, this situation here. Let's call this part situation M, and let's call this situation N. Let's put this equation separately so that we can understand. So that's the one equation here. Another equation is this. T minus 3 will also have to equal 5 times n. Since this is T minus 3 and this is T minus 3, we are almost done. This is T minus, which means this implies that 4 times m, this implies that 4 times m would have to equal 5 times n, right here. Now what does that tell you? What does this equation tell us? 4 times m equals 5 times n. What does it tell us? It tells us that the total number of people, you see, this is 24 times m equals 5 times n. That tells us that, this tells us that this quantity that we're looking at, t minus 3, in both cases, t minus 3 equals this quantity, 3 minus 3 equals this quantity. That tells us that t minus 3 is a multiple is a multiple, has to be multiple, t minus 3, this quantity 3 minus 3, must be a multiple of both 4 and 5. Both 4 and 5. What do we gather from that? It has to be multiple of both 4 and 5. And it lies only between 10 and 40. It only lies between 10 and 40. The only number that is a multiple of both 4 and 5, listen very carefully, the only number that is a multiple of both 4 and 5 that lies in this range between 10 and 40 is 20. No other number between 10 and 40 can be divided by both 4 and 5. No other number. We know the total number of people in the club. We know the total number of people in the club has to be either 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, all the way up to 39. Between 11 and 39, there is no number that can be divided by 4 and 5, only 20. So that tells us, this implies that t minus 3 must be 20. And that in return implies that t must be 20 plus 3 or 23. The total number of members in the club is 23, but we are not done yet. That wasn't the question. The question was not how many members there are in the club. I hope 23 is not one of the answer choices. It's not. 23 is not one of the answer choices. They're not asking how many people there are in the club. That was only half the story. Now let's answer the question that is being asked. The question that is being asked is this. If this set, where can I squeeze it? I left no room at all. Let's put it way up on the top. This is the question. The question is, if they sit 6 at each table, remember we have already established that there are 23. This implies that 6 times 3 is 18. The question was, how many people will be sitting at the odd table? If they decide to sit 6 at each table, then the last table, which of course will not have 6 people, that was the whole question. The question was, let me read the question the way it's written here. It says, if they sit at tables with 6 members at each table, except one, and fewer than 6 members at that particular table, where there are few, the odd table that is, how many members will sit at the table that has fewer than 6 members? The answer is 5, because this is 18, the total is 23, since there are a total of 23, that tells us that we must have 3 tables where 6 people are sitting, or rather, where 6 people are sitting, we must have 3 tables with 6 people sitting, 6 times 3 is 18, and there must be 5 people at the odd one. One table where we have fewer than 6 people, but that table has 5 people. That's it, we are done. Let's go on to the next one. The answer is E. Number 19 is an algebra word problem, so we'll take our time and go step by step, that's all it is. Number 19. We are told that we had planned to read 90 pages per day. That was our plan. Our big plan was to read 90 pages per day to prepare for the exam for n days. The n is our unknown. That in turn implies that if we had planned to read 90 pages per day for a few days, for a given number of days, which we are calling n, that in turn implies that the total number of pages that we had to read must have been, let's call it T, must have been 90 times N. That's our first equation. The the total number of pages has to be 90 times n if we had planned to read 90 pages per page for n number of days. Let's continue. It turns out, as always, it turns out that people do not usually follow through their plan. They make this gung-ho plan and then they fall behind sometimes. It turns out that, but we managed to read only 75 pages. Only 75 pages per day for the first few days. And of course, they do not tell you how many days, obviously. That will be too simple. First few days. We're going to call these first few days F. F stands for the first few days. So if we read 75 pages per day, for the first few days, that implies that we must have read 75 times F pages, 75 times F pages in the first few days. You see how the story is building? That in turn implies that the pages that are left unread, at that stage in the game, after the first few days, the pages that are still to be read, must have been the total number of pages that we have to read, which is 90 times n, minus the number of pages that we managed to read, which is 75 times f. Voila! Are you with me? It's very simple. You just have to go slowly, logically, rationally. That's what algebra is. Algebra word problems are not that difficult. You just have to follow what is told to you, the instructions, in a logical, rational, calm manner. That's what it is. Then they go on to say that we read the remaining 690 pages. Aha, 690 pages. This is this quantity right here. 90 times n minus 75 times s, which are the pages unread, which is the remaining pages. They go on to tell us that this quantity, they just told us that 90 times n minus 75 times f equals 690. We read the remaining 690 pages in the last 6 days. Last 6 days. Now what does that tell us? If they tell us that we read the remaining pages in the last 6 days, that in turn implies that the first few days, which we represented as F here, must have been the number of days that we had assigned for us to read these pages here, total number of pages, minus the 6. We had planned to do this project in n number of days. Then we are told what happened in the first few days. Well, first few days is what we call F. And then they go on to tell us in the last remaining 6 days. Well, there you have, which means that F plus the 6 must have been the total number of days. You see, F, which is the first few days, plus the 6 remaining days, must have been the total number of days. This is the same, of course, as that. That's it, we are done. All we have to do now is to set up the equation. We know these are the remaining pages. Okay, let me highlight this thing so we can see what we're going to do here. These are the remaining pages right here. These are the remaining pages, 690. And these are the remaining pages. So 690 equals this. That's our first equation. Here is our second equation. That's it, we are done. At this point, all we have here are two simple linear independent equations with two unknowns. We just have to solve for the two unknowns. That's all it is. We are done. The rest is downhill. We have done the difficult part. Let's put the equation on the top. Because we need the room, obviously. We are running out of room here. Just give me one quick break here. So here is our equation. The remaining pages, has to equal total pages minus the pages read in the first few days. I really need to erase everything because this is going to be otherwise too much. The remaining pages, which we are told are 690, has to equal the total number of pages, which we said we had planned to read 90 pages per day for n number of days. This is the total number of pages. The pages that we read in the first few days were 75 pages per day for the first few days, which is our F. That's it. And here is our F. F equals n equals F plus n. And what are they looking for? They're looking for n. So that's it, we are done. Since they're looking since we're looking for n right here, n equals F plus 6. We're gonna put it right in here. N equals F plus 6. Let's put it right in here. So it's 90 times n, which is F plus 6. F plus 6 minus 75F equals 690. That's it. Well, this is going to end up actually giving us F, but that's not what we wanted here. We're looking for the value of n. What is the question asking? How many days in all did Terry have to complete the assignment? We're looking for total number of. We could actually continue here and then solve for it. Since I set it up, let's continue here. Let's not make a fuss. Let's erase this thing. We need the room. And see what happens. So 90 times F is just 90F. 90 times 6. But we know 9, 6 are 54. So 90 times 6 is going to be 540. 540 minus 75F. 90F minus 75F is going to give us 15F equals 15F plus 540 equals 690. Let's subtract 540 from both sides. 540 drops out, and 15F is going to give us 690 minus 540. 90 minus 40 is 50, so it's 150. Oh, this is very simple. Oh, this is how nice of them, isn't it? That's so nice. F equals 10, and therefore n, which was 6 more than that, is just 16. Boy, that wasn't so bad at all. But as you can see, the last part is very simple. It's downhill. Now we have to do question number 120, which I'm going to squeeze in right here. Question number 120 is a silly question. The last question on the page, question number 120 right here. It's a very silly question. Because here's what they're giving us. S, they're told, that equals R over S, the square root of R over S. And the question is, how much is R? Take the square of both sides. If you take the square of both sides, what we find is that S squared equals R over S. Multiply both sides by S, multiply this side by S, multiply that side by S, and S drops out, and R equals S cubed. As I said, that was a very silly question. That's it. The answer is D. And that was the very last problem on the page, and that's where we're going to stop, okay? Tomorrow, we'll begin the new page. Bye now.